am probably a good leader. This is a challenge to those who sit back here. I want to use my natural voice. Those who are sitting here will hear me. And so if you don't hear me, you can come for me. Yes. I'm not going to use the title honorables, but I do so much recognize the protocol. We have DPAA, DPFA, the Dean, faculty head of department, and the various assessors who were involved in this exercise. Some lecturers who are present in here, staff, as well as students, and more importantly, the five contestants. And I'm sure there were some who shied away before they got to the end. So we also recognize those. These are five actually got to the end. So I so much honor and respect everyone who is in this room. I'm so much pleased actually to have this opportunity to talk to a wider audience than the one that I had the privilege to meet at the beginning. DPAA said that maybe I should talk about why did I do this. But I think between him and the head of department, the dean, they have actually preempted me. All the kind of ideas, the reasons that were there have already been stated. But sometimes it's important to hear from the horse's mouth. And I would say that there were several reasons why I got it. Of course, the first and foremost was the critique to the announcement that was brought. And this letter was brought to me as principal, and it didn't mean that I had to criticize. I was supposed just to receive the invitation and act on it. But I was interested from the theme of the conference or the meeting, which is historical. And being a historian myself, I looked at it, but I didn't find any history in it, and I was surprised. So I said, what should I do? I have done church history myself from the perspective of a story, the history of Tanzania, of evangelization and all the missionary activities. I have done on several occasions, I've presented papers, and so I even was tempted that should I volunteer to make a paper and go there and say, please give me space and let me teach you. I'm a lay person and I will be talking to the clergy, and these are the ones who prepared this outline. I say, no, maybe that would be too much. I will seem like arrogant or whatever. So this is their business. They have invited me to go there, the principal. So let me keep cool. But the idea was still kind of storming in my mind and my heart, and said, no, we need to do something. Then I looked at Duke in one aspect as one of those institutions of higher learning in Tanzania that is charged with the training and preparation of people who are going to be clergy one day. But at the same time, I think we at JUCO are the ones who are standing forefront in Tanzania when it comes to theology as well as philosophy. And I said, so why can't we do something? Then something came into mind that when we had the community day, I did go around and I was quite new here, and people took me, say, we have community. And what is community day? So I went around different kibanda, and when I went to the kibanda of theology, I asked them, because I was so interested, what would theology show in community? So how God can be presented physically. So my interest was actually to see God, something there. And but when I went there, among the issues that were presented was this, the church history and about how church Christianity got into Tanzania and how it went round. And I asked them, is this theology? Someone told me, yes, it is theology, because we have to know how Christianity got here before we start analyzing the actually theological things. I said, okay, fine, if this is theology, then at least I have a quarter of it. I'm a theologian. So that itself again came in my mind in view of this matter, and I said, okay, if that is the case, why can't I challenge theologians to do this? And then we need those who have advanced in theology to do something. And that is when I consulted the DPEA to guide me and get to class. And we actually invaded the class. And I'm so grateful to Father John, who was there in the class, and said, can I have 5 minutes of your class so that I can talk about something? So that is it. So one, first and foremost, was challenge to this. Now, what does that mean? That means when we get something, when we see something, we should not take for granted, just take the normal, regular, so things as usual, matters as usual, business as usual. Try to be critical. And that is one thing that you have to learn. If you are to emulate, as the DPEA was saying, emulate from there. That number one. Be critical with whatever you encounter. Ask questions. And sometimes you find, even in normal life, when you meet someone and then this someone went ahead and did something bad and you are called to the police to be a witness, they will ask you, which shirt did you wear? Which color of shirt? Actually, I'm not sure. Are you sure you told us that, yes, I really met him at the door, but I didn't even observe the shirt? That is very common. How tall was that? I'm not sure, because I was just in a hurry going this way and he was getting out. These are very common. So let us be critical, observers, thinkers, as scholars. That is number one. So this is actually to submit a message to that effect. But my second point that I would like to drive to you is that is what DPEA was saying. That it has little to do with students, but rather to do with staff. I think my first public, presentation to staff was on the issues of what is most important. This was for academic staff. What actually entails an academic institution like JUCO? And I said the main weakness that we have at JUCO is something to do with research and publication. We are weak in that. We may be strong, of course, even teaching. Some other people observing can say, yes, even teaching we have some problems, but relatively. And I said an academic institution of tertiary level has more than just teaching, because otherwise it becomes an elevated secondary school. Research and publication is very important. So while fulfilling this assignment that I had in my mind, I also wanted to challenge these fourth year theology students, some of whom tomorrow will be our tutorial assistants and assistant lecturers, etc., to look at this issue of writing as something doable. And doing library research, for them, they did mainly library research and desktop research, computers, etc. center collecting information. So this is something doable. You can do and write something that can be presented to other people and say, yes, something acceptable. So it is possible. And these people, unfortunately, it was not my intention that to put them under pressure, that to have them do it during the time when they prepare for examinations. Yet they have proven that it is possible. Even under pressure, you can come up with something reasonable. I mean, they have written between 550 to 750 words, okay, during this time. And this is the range of an article in any international journal. So it's doable. So actually, yes, it was my intention that to challenge, to make sure that we cultivate this habit of publishing, writing and publishing, and because it was also stated, I stated to them that those who are going to win, apart from getting the award to go to Bagamoyo to do, to observe a meeting that is related to theology, then they can also have their papers published in Africa Tomorrow, a journal that is published here. So, and that will be based on the assessment that the assessors find, but also the editor. If the editor is pleased, maybe not only the two of them, but also the five of them could be published. If that is the case, then fine, they can be published, maybe in different series or in one, because there will be some issues that are repetitive, but the editor can find how it can be. So, and it's very important for one to publish when you are at this level. I remember my first paper to be published, academic paper, was when I was in third year at the University of Dar es Salaam. And actually it came from a take-home essay that I was given by my instructor. I wrote it and the instructor said, this is excellent, Bertram. You can actually publish this. Just add this, do this and this. So I would so much be appreciative if the head of department and the instructors in theology can check it up and then maybe encourage these and those who are on that kind of vision to get into publishing this. My third part and third component of all this has to do with the importance of theology. And here I would like to ask on not only theology, but theology and philosophy. But this time, yes, it was an opportune time to have something to do with theology. Theology and philosophy are two disciplines that are grand disciplines for Jews. Whether you know or you don't. But this is, as the new principle, this is what I'm looking at. I look at theology and philosophy as the two disciplines that are here to take Juku to where we want to go. Why? Because there is no other discipline at the present time that we are offering that is so unique to us than the two. When I say so, I don't want to undermine other disciplines. No. But I want to show the importance of the two, particularly in branding. It may be a new verb, but what it means is simply something that you identify with, something that you think you can actually take up and be boldly and with confidence say, this is me. And this is And idea, we have actually several other institutions among those that are under Sauti and even at national level. They have not been able to identify themselves who they are. For an institution like this, we need to have programs that we say, these are what identify us, and we'll have other programs that are going around with them so that we go. Today, if we wanted to compete in law, for example, if we wanted to have JUKU be the best in law, we have a tough road to make. We have to beat University of Dar es Salaam, for example, which had an old, it's the oldest university and the oldest university program in Tanzania is law. And it was established at the University of Dar es Salaam, 1961. So you have to work very hard to beat University of Dar es Salaam in law. So that is what I'm saying in short. I don't want to exhaust you so much. But theology and philosophy. So we need to work hard. So it was my identification and appreciation of this and showing the importance of these programs for JUKU that I said we need to do something. And probably at this juncture, I should take the opportunity also to confess that I did actually even discuss a little bit with BPAA and challenged him with one task, and I'm yet to get report, that we want theology and philosophy to be the first programs to start PhD at JUKU. And this is something that is in the near future, not more than 2 years to come. We have the scholars, we have PhDs, and that, why can't we? Why shouldn't we? So the only need is that you have stuff. Of course, you have to have also books. It's not that difficult to find the kind of advanced books that we need, and that is it. So we are going towards that direction, is for that. So it's not a secret that this, competition, activity, whatever, fell in the hands of theology. And much as you could find that, yes, this is something good, blessing, but it comes with a challenge. So we have started the journey. Today I'm doing this sacrifice, I really call it sacrifice, to give almost 1 million of the money that my kids, my wife, and whoever would have enjoyed. I deposit it in theology as seed. One of the writers has used the word mustard. I think we all know the mustard seed. I saw it in one of the competitions. So this 1,000 should be mustard seed, which we want to see in the next 2, 3, 4, 5 years, we have theology at Jordan University excelling as being world-class theology. That people coming from America, from China, from Malaysia, from all over the world, to Jordan University to do theology and philosophy. It should not be just a business as usual. So it is only through that that the seed that I sow today will really be appreciated by my heart. And probably you should know that I don't easily give out my I don't. One should not get the image that maybe because I'm a professor or whatever that I have money. No. And in principle, if you are going for wedding, please, I should be the last person to come to ask for contribution. I don't contribute for wedding unless I don't know. I also am not a person who easily contributes to funeral. No, I don't. Much as people would shed tears, please come to me when you are diseased, was in hospital. That is when you get my money and I am so pleased. If I say I don't have, really I don't have. Because your patient is there in the hospital, and maybe my 10,000, my 20,000 can actually give him or her medication that can make him live 2 days more. That is prudent, in my view. And not to come to me and say, we don't have 3 crates of beer, and those who mourn there, they need to drink overnight so that tomorrow we start our travel trip to Moshi to go and bury our... What is that? No. Similarly with wedding, I don't know, but I don't want to give explanation there. But what I'm saying is that come to me when you don't have 20,000 to complete your fees. I find that being prudent. In fact, I have been, when I was principal of the University of Dar es Salaam, I find a student coming to me asking for postponement of classes. I say, why? Because I didn't pay this, I can't register. I say, where are you from? I'm from Musoma. Oh, are you alone here? No. I say, who you know from Musoma? Bring those people to me. You bring 3, 5, whatever. So they don't know what I'm doing. They come there. I say, okay, this gentleman doesn't have 200,000 to complete his fee so that he can do his exam. Do you tell me that you guys from Musoma can't contribute 5,000 each to enable this person to continue with his studies? You know, principal, we don't have money. And I say, okay, I'm going to contribute 100,000. And I want you by tomorrow, you have the rest of the money in this gentleman should continue to school. That I have done. And I'm not saying I'm going to do, because some people say, now we have to do. Probably I've done it enough. So what I'm saying is that that is my principle. So don't think that I give money out easily, no. So this time when I decided to do this, and that it is because of this, is a contribution not to the 2 individuals that are going to Bagamoyo, is for Juko, that we have started a very important race. Probably more than you know. It's not business as usual. We are here on a very important race. And we want, after 5 years, to really mark where we were and where So it's not easy. And indeed, we need actually a sacrifice, and we need actually spirit, heart of every one of us and those who are with us to make this serious mark to changing JUCO to a super institution that we will sit down and say, we were there during the formation days. So, dear DPA and DPFA, Dean, and all others, this is what message I wanted to send you. But before I conclude, I would like to sincerely appreciate the contribution of all those who made this occasion possible, starting from the class and the lecturer, and head of department has done all the coordination, the PE, supervision of activities, the assessors who wasted their time doing this much, and those who got into competition. I should reiterate that there were some who did not get to the end, but they started. Even when you have Kilimanjaro Marathon, you have those who just go there for jogging. They take only 100 meters, they are exhausted. But they're important in the race, because if you are only the 5 winners, you start, it won't at least go to the end. Now we are waiting to see who is the winner. And the coordinators didn't even want to tell me the secret, so they wanted to make me have surprise just as the winner themselves. So that is what happened. But I so much appreciate the contribution of everyone, and thank you for coming this afternoon or evening. Thank you for listening to Asante Sana.